Okay, so I realized some things yesterday after streaming, namely that I hadn't actually been using my right microphone. I was using the one that was internally built into my computer, so my audio unfortunately came across pretty bad. So I'm kind of redoing this for a couple of reasons. Firstly, I want to check out if I actually have that additional elusive episode that they mentioned. And if not, I still need to play my second save file that I chose different things in because I want to see how the differences pan out. Let's see. Let me adjust the audio here. Okay, I might have to reopen it real quick. NP, no problem. It'll be fine. Waiting for that to open up. I know what I need to do to make it run better. Be less laggy. Oh no, I'm stuck. I might have to bump up the priority again, but for now I'll put it on above average. When I had it on high, it was a little bit eh. The introductory cutscenes are still an issue as far as I know, but let me see if this changes that. If not, let's see. Okay, now. Okay, so there's supposedly another episode, right? Like, that's what they said or something. I thought it was supposed to be like goodbyes or something. I don't know. I have the deluxe editions. I really don't know. To be like logged into Square Enix or something. Let's just go to, I guess, back, 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 back. Well, dang. I really thought they said that in the deluxe edition there's a another episode. Let me see my choices. Oh. Oh, it's 50-50 now. That was interesting. Okay. So here's that. And there's that. Huh, okay. Let's try this again. Hopefully I don't fuck up as much this time. Did I not finish the second one? Oh, I might have to do some quick finishing up of this episode leading into the next. That's fine by me, but hopefully nobody else minds. Continue then. Okay, time to get going. See, I think I might have a little bit of the second episode left. Might. See if it does a recap. Oh, did I just not finish this at all?
How do you know which way is up when your whole life has been turned upside down?
Why? Okay, and work on stuff.
Black Call's done with me. I can't go home anymore. Is this junkyard all I've got left?
Here we go.
Ugh. This thing is a mess. But maybe I can fix it.
And fix it I will. Wait a second. Bad man.
Let's see what else this trash heap has to offer.
Well, mannequin head, apparently. Let's reflect on how mad I was at Rachel. Oh, wait a second. I know what's wrong here. I need to remap my stuff real quick. Give me a second. My normal keys don't work, so... So what's giving this WASD crap for? I don't understand. Okay. There we go.
Guess I was pretty pissed at Rachel last night. Amazing that someone I just met could have made me this angry. Max and I used to go there all the time as kids. I think it shut down, but who knows?
Oh, I can actually look at my hand. I never realized that. Neat. That's something.
Don't tell me what to do.
Okay. For reals, though, let's see. Wait, what was I looking for again? Which button was it? Ah, darn it. Forget how to look at my objectives. A syringe. Ooh. Not what I need to be looking for, though. Let's go take this guy's engine, because...
Wow. Shitty ride, drug dealer. Really thought crime paid better.
Ooh. Burn. Let's see now. Oh, burn. The irony. Right, okay, so... What am I supposed to be doing? How do I look at my hand? It's one of these buttons. No. I have to check again. Mouse sensitivity would be great if it was a bit higher. Yeah. There we go. Then we're free. Now let's see. Key bindings. Okay, so it is... Actually, it really doesn't say, does it? Oh, right click. Psh, that's why none of the other buttons were working. That explains some things. But hey, now I can move around quicker. Or, well, relatively. What am I trying to do here? Okay, let's see. Get battery put in truck. Okay, well, I mean, let's be real. Battery is going to need to come from that truck. But I guess I have to go check the other cars because, fuck it. I don't know. How do I know which cars are cars I can check? Okay, that's a trunk. That won't do. Let's see, is there anything in here? Nah. Okay, I guess I can check this pile of crap. Or maybe not. Okay. Dude, come on, Chloe. It's pretty obvious what needs to be done here. Okay, let me guess, I have to check this one first. Doesn't even let me close enough to it to have the action prompt. Come on. Okay, let's look at the school bus because surely I can get an engine from a school bus.
Guess I'll never ride one of these again. That's so awesome.
Okay. Now let's see. Guess I'm not moving any bricks. This is definitely not gonna...
No, not going over there.
No, going over here instead. Or not. Come on, man. Not very cool. I don't know what I'm supposed to do here. You're not looking. Boat. No.
Damn, you cigarettes.
Okay, here we go. Let's fix this up. Right on. Aye, aye.
Shit.
Right. Well, their battery in here. Okay.
I can't believe Rachel set that fire. I don't think she meant to, but I also don't think she didn't mean to. Crazy that something so destructive can also be so beautiful. Or a fire that began in a trash can grow to light up the entire sky. In conclusion, fire. Pretty sweet.
Sweet or sick. I'm not sure if this is actually necessary for me to, like, get up here or whatnot. I've now to climb down. Okay, wait, a HUD. Oh, yes.
What do I want to tell my fellow sailors of the seven trash heaps?
Oh.
Got it.
Oh, the irony. My choice right now, oh, the irony. Too good. Right on, Chloe, go off, go for it. Captain Bluebeard, okay. I don't think I've ever used that one. Yeah, okay. Onwards. Right, so I was like looking at things for stuff and let's get battery put in track. Right, okay, so since I don't seem to want to look at anything, I don't know what I'm supposed to do to continue. No. Do I need the bat? I doubt it.
I think I'm all smashed out. For now.
Okay, let's see.
Not sure what's wrong with the engine, or how to fix it. Not yet, anyway.
Hey. There's a license plate right there. That's very convenient, actually. But where am I supposed to be looking? I didn't get that. That's where I was stuck last time. I mean, I gotten past this. That's not it. It's just, I don't remember. Is there something I'm supposed to do before it cues me to allow me to go on to the next section? That's what I'm not sure about. Honestly, it's kind of frustrating. No, that's not it. Oh, wait, why, you know, walk over plank? Come on. Dude, what am I supposed to... How am I supposed to... When I can't... You know what? Whatever.
I used to love opening up the diner with Mom before school. I guess those days are now officially over.
What realization am I supposed to make? Okay, so, like, obviously I need this engine. It's a
Wow.
Okay.
Shitty ride, drug dealer. Really thought crime paid better.
It's not even that bad of a truck, dude. Come on.
Here's a side of Arcadia Bay they don't put on the postcards.
Yes. Do I have to examine everything first? Like, really? Really? Okay, let's go full circle. Push the boundaries of where I can go. Let's do this in a hustle. Okay, yeah, I can't get that. No, I can't use that either. Use that. Just switch the camera around. Dang. Okay, let's run this way, I guess. Huh. I'd already looked at that. A toy robot. No more arigato, Mr. Robot.
It's all fun and games till this guy enslaves everyone.
That crap revolution. Wait. Smutmatic? What's that?
These magazines are so gross. Who would look at this? Okay, I'm still looking. It's only because I'm so fixated by how weird it is.
Uh-huh. Okay. Wait, what? What's this? A fire poker? Oh, wait a second. Right.
I know one fire that doesn't need any poking.
So I'm supposed to have that cutscene. Right. Okay. With the dad.
And up next, a local band called Pisshead is blowing minds and speakers throughout the bay. Here's their new single, Nothing Wrong.
All right.
A pirate flag? Wonder if there's treasure buried nearby.
Buried.
Yeah, You're a long way from the country club, guy.
Posters? Alright, this is for the old Vortex Club.
This is a Vortex Club. I wouldn't mind joining.
That's pretty awesome. Okay, let's see. Christmas lights. Well, 'tis the season.
Gotta love a place where even Christmas looks depressing.
For reals. Let's see. Now that I've gone full circle. Rug. Right.
This rug has some miles on it.
Now that I've essentially searched just about everywhere I can think of. Am I supposed to, check this car? Maybe? No? I don't know.
Puddles, bottles everywhere, and not one beer to drink.
True. True facts.
Sorry, Max. I think I'm more jealous of you than anything. Hopefully, I'll be escaping this place soon, too.
Toolbox? Wait, what? Glass shards? Why am I looking at these things?
Glass looks way prettier when it's broken. Wonder what else that's true for. First you take my mom, then you take my home. Fuck you, David. Not sure what's wrong with the
Okay, this is getting annoying.
How to fix it. Not yet, anyway.
Okay. This is getting a little bit irritating. Oh, here we go, finally. God.
No, I can't.
Wait. No, that's the dad's right, okay. Why can't I just pick the mansion out? Come on, I know what I need to do. I've done it before. I just don't know why it's not letting me do it now. I don't understand. It feels like a glitch. Maybe. Maybe it's a glitch. Oh, hey. It's like I have to approach it from a certain angle or something. I have to, like, make the bird fly away a certain amount of times or some shit, like... William Wallace? Who's that? Maybe it's a bug other people are experiencing too. Like right there would be a perfect place to like try to check for an engine, say. No, actually maybe not if that's the trunk, but I don't think it is. Dude. Then again, how if I know? Everything's upside down and backwards here. Ugh. Maybe I should check like a guide or something. This will make me, it makes me feel stupid. Like, sincerely. It should not be this difficult. It's like, what am I missing? Do I need to re-examine things? Do I need to go walk?
Don't want to leave yet.
Okay, I know really I'm not supposed to have to, whatever. Let's look at the sign though. Yep, that's a sign, it sure is.
American Rust. Sounds about right.
Did you get hella get tetanus here? What are, of course that wouldn't cross the minds of people in a game. Of course. Hello, car I'm absolutely not having anything to do with yet again. Because I'm still looking for a goddamn engine, which I already know where it is. Oh, goodness. Like, this is getting kind of pretty irritating. Like, maybe I have to go into my hideout or something. God dang it.
Don't want to leave yet.
Okay. Okay, I'm gonna look it up real quick because I think it might be a glitch, and if it isn't, I don't know what to do. Okay, so really quickly. This is part two, and I don't even know how much time I spent, like, on my own trying to find the battery before. I do remember it took like a bit, but I knew what it, where it was. Strange Before the Storm. Episode 2. Car battery. Let's see. What can we find here? Loading. Loading. Loading yet still. Our battery. Please help. Internet.
But first.
Wait, what's going on here? Hold on. I have Twitch open. On my other past video with the bad mic. Oops. My bad.
How do I destroy love?
Close that? Oh no, my cat is over here. No, stay out of this, pause. This doesn't involve you. You don't want to get involved with this scene. Okay. Okay, it is a multiple save glitch. Okay, let's see if there's a fix for this or something. Up the bobblehead again. It looks like it was a glitch. What is it? Saving some time between the start of the game and the last save before you have control in the junkyard. The program in the game writes the value of save one on your save two file. Edit this likely, there's likely a programming error where it is loading things from save file one and two, likely because hard coded. Okay, basically they don't even know. Oh, there's a workaround. Okay, good. This is what I need. Workaround time. Fixing mechanical issues with mechanical issues. Maybe I should make like a quick video about how to fix it, if it's not on the internet already. Oh, it just says if you're going to start a second playthrough, don't. Okay. Oh no, I don't want to have to restart the chapter. Okay. Oh. It's a very long workaround. Weird. Okay, well, Roll PC configuration. Wait, what? 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 It says I have to like completely. Man. Okay, first. Disable Steam Cloud Sync to prevent the game from downloading unwanted save files from cloud. File, make a backup in the entire folder, copy to some other place. Okay. 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 I think I understand what to do. To go through my documents and sort out some crap, though. It won't take very long, I don't think. Now that I understand what the problem might be. So I just need to locate it in the Steam folder, basically copy the files, move the files from folder 1 to folder 2, no, folder 2 to folder 1, to trick the game into thinking that's the actual original file, I think, and keep it someplace else, from what I understand. Okay, let's see. Okay. App data, local low. The pain, I'm sorry about this. Wait a sec. Okay, so get to that part. so first I turn the sink off on Steam. Just by going to the games page. Picking settings. Disable Cloud Sync. Okay. To re-enable that, but save files on your disk apps. Yeah. App data. That's what I thought. Seems to be misguiding me here. Let me try looking for the folder. Otherwise, I mean, I guess when push comes to shove, I could just like replay episode 3, but. That's still an annoyance. Yeah, okay, whatever. I'm just gonna restart the. I'm gonna continue the game on my other save file because fuck this, this is taking way too long. Save files. Save file 1. Okay, good. Key bindings are still the same. Video settings. I don't feel like the qualities need to be that high. Go with this, whatever. Oh, okay. Then after this, I need to make sure that I don't know what the hell it is with the audio, dude. Yes, I want to keep these configurations. Game, please. No. Okay. So. But this is the video option thing, right? Thank you. Just... Okay. There we go. This feels a little better. A little bit better. My mouth still feels sluggish though. A little bit higher. Yes. Okay. It's a little bit of a way, but I'm just hoping that the actual sound of it is okay. Like, okay. I'm sorry in advance if it skips. This. That was empty. What? I don't know what this does, but okay. Well, I guess everybody's re-experiencing it with me. Personally, I have no problem with this. I need to explore my different options here. And the different outcomes. So I guess we'll find out.
Previously on Life is Strange Before the Storm. I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was.
There is plenty of blame to go around.
What does that mean?
You forced my hand. This is a consequence of your actions, Chloe.
We both agree that the best thing for everyone at this stage is for me to move in.
In a million years, I never thought you'd choose David over me.
Hey!
Black Hole's done with me. I can't go home anymore. Is this junkyard all I've got left?
Drew runs Oxy for Damon. Go to Drew's room, find the money, and I'll meet you to pick it up.
Whatever you do, don't open the door.
Oh, I want my fucking money!
Juliet is wailing. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our aerial.
No fucking chance.
I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle.
Rachel, please.
The world are mere prologue. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish?
Yes. Let's leave. For real. If you don't mean this, it's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen.
What would it take to convince you?
Why can't you just tell me the fucking truth?
Rachel.
Oh, man.
That woman you saw. That wasn't my mistress. That was your mother.
Resuming. Now, hopefully, it'll no stutter now. Just cutscenes. Please, please, please. Please. And honestly, I mean, come on. I'm adopted. It shouldn't be that big of a deal. Shouldn't have been made that big of a deal, anyways.
I want to tell you all of it. But are you sure that Chloe should be here for.
Chloe stays.
Of course.
In every way that matters, Rose is my wife and your mother. But the woman you saw at the Overlook, her name is Sarah. Your birth mother. I'm going to tell you everything, Rachel. Everything I've shielded you from for so long. But the truth can be hard to look at. Is this really something you're ready for?
Chloe.
I'm right here. Good. I need you.
It's not like there's really any... lens of truth, huh? And here we are again.
When I was in high school, there was one person everyone adored. Her teachers, her friends. Sarah was everyone's favorite. Every boy wanted to date her. I could barely believe it when she picked me. Sometimes, I think that's what kept me blind for so long.
Why is this sounding familiar? Surely it's not foreshadowing.
She was so alive, so passionate about everything. Early on, though, I realized I wasn't enough for her. While the rest of us were pursuing college, careers, families, Sarah wasn't looking for any of that. She was looking for escape.
Too relatable. Way too relatable. Uncomfortably so. Well,
when Sarah became pregnant, I thought it would solve everything. And it did. For a little while. Becoming your father was the greatest moment of my life. There was so much love, but I was still blind.
Here we go.
However much she loved you then, it wasn't enough. For Sarah, the need to escape was always there. Over a year, I tried to help her. I made myself believe that she was still a good person.
What is she trying to escape from, though?
That no matter what happened, she would never do anything to hurt you. Was wrong. Eventually, I saw her for who she really was. A destructive person. Someone who could never be satisfied. Anyone or anything. Even the love of her own daughter. I was desperate. I didn't know what to do.
So I made a choice. I was never going to let her harm you again.
All too familiar story.
What you saw at the Overlook, Rachel, it was true. We kissed. It was the saddest kiss of my life. It was a kiss goodbye. I told her that I was happy for her, that she felt like she'd gotten her life together. Finally. But she didn't get to just decide one day to be a mother. Not after what she'd done. Not after all the people she hurt. All the lives she destroyed.
This kind of pisses me off.
She'd been given the greatest gift in the world. Chance to be your mother. And she squandered it.
Honestly, this disgusts me.
To hurt her like that. But I'd do it again. And again. And again. To keep you safe.
What though? Like the... So what are you trying to protect her from? What are you so scared of? It's like, are you scared you'll lose her? Scared she'll become like her?
So that was the first time you've seen her or spoken with her in 15 years?
No. I send her money. Every single month. It's our arrangement.
But now, she wants to see me?
Yes. But Rachel, it cannot be.
Why not? If that's what Rachel wants.
Drug addiction is a disease. It afflicts everyone, not just the addict. I will not allow you to be victimized by her disease again.
Even if that's true, Rachel could still meet her. And maybe the fact that she wants to see me means she's gotten better.
Maybe so. But consider that for 15 years, she's preferred that money to you.
But people change.
Rachel. I think I need to lie down.
Girl. It's her choice to make, not theirs. As parents, their job should be to respect it, especially at this point in her life. No is no, just... ulterior motives much?
I can't leave Rachel to deal with this alone.
Let's revisit the fact that he has files on her.
Whoa. Sarah Gearhart is a known associate of that psycho who attacked Drew. Then again, so is Frank.
Okay.
Rachel only knew half the truth when she set that fire. What if she'd known everything?
Good question. I wonder why it's so baffling.
I hope tonight hasn't messed up Rachel's memories of family trips like this. The Tempest show feels so far away now. This is so painful to look at.
How to incognito death. Fail much. My goodness. Nod face. Okay, anyways. Oh, what's this?
This seems like a James and Rose bookshelf. I can't imagine Sarah here instead.
I don't know.
I can't even imagine how she must be feeling. Hey, Mrs. Amber.
I think it's Rose at this point, considering everything.
Okay, Rose. Sorry that tonight turned out so differently.
That's all right. I'm really quite glad that you're here.
Thanks. But why?
While Rachel's dealing with all of this, it's a relief to know she can talk to you. How are you doing, Chloe?
Oh, God.
How am I doing?
Your generation loves to talk about how awkward different things are. Well, this must be pretty awkward, I'd imagine.
Guess I'm not great. Rachel and I were really happy a few hours ago, and now...
Maybe you can see why James wanted to keep this a secret. There are many painful things about Rachel's past, including my own role in hiding the truth.
It doesn't matter how painful it is. You don't lie to someone you love.
You might be right. But can any of us really know what we would do in his situation?
No, but...
He's been a devoted father for 15 years. I know he loves Rachel more than anything.
I'm surprised you're defending him after what he did at the Overlook.
It might be hard for you to understand, but after 13 years of marriage, I'm not threatened by what happened.
Right. I don't understand.
You don't have to worry about me or James. Rachel's the one who needs you right now.
Do you think Sarah is dangerous?
I've never met her, so I don't know. But I'm inclined to trust my husband. His entire life is about keeping people safe. Rachel's extremely fortunate to have him as her father.
Thanks.
Thank you, Chloe.
ever. Joke.
It's so weird to look at this now. Wonder what James is thinking right now. This must be hard for you too, Master Amber.
It could be far worse. My biggest fear is that Rachel will try to meet Sarah. I've dreaded it.
So that's why you never told her?
You have no idea what pain Sarah's caused.
Her addiction
has led her to do terrible things. I don't want Rachel to go through any of that.
I don't understand. Are you afraid that Sarah would do something to Rachel?
I don't think she would deliberately harm anyone. But addicts can cause tremendous harm without meaning to.
Yeah. But Rachel's not a baby anymore.
Listen to me. Sarah brought criminals and drug dealers into our home. She put Rachel in serious danger just to chase her habit.
You think Sarah is involved with any of the drug dealers around here?
It wouldn't surprise me if she were. That's who she is. Chloe, I believe Rachel trusts you more than anyone else right now.
Is this where you ask me to manipulate Rachel into doing what you want?
Exactly.
This is what I ask you to do as your conscience dictates. But please, put my daughter's safety first.
Maybe try the truth for a change?
What do you mean?
Well, you did lie to your daughter for 15 years.
This is true. And that's why I need your help. I only care about Rachel, Chloe.
Do what I can. I care about her too, you know?
I know. Thank you.
Normally, I'm not the person I'd be wanting to keep peace, but in this situation, it's too
hard to argue that Rachel would have had a better life with Sarah. But does that make what James did right?
Exactly. That's exactly it. It doesn't make what he did right. It doesn't justify it. She has the right to know. Make her own choices. Ironically.
Some way to show Rachel that I'm here for her.
Naturally.
She has so many inspirations, she can barely keep them all contained.
Mm-hmm.
Rachel even knows how to make a dinky lamp look cool. Rachel's surrounded by so much love, yet she seems so... alone.
Talk about it. I'm noticing a trend here, though. And I find it funny because... well...
it makes sense that Rachel needs two signs to contain her awesomeness. I shall call her Lion Crab from now on.
I also am on the cusp of oscillation. Does that make me a lion crab? Oh, man. I wonder if they made this with her in mind, or if they made the character based off of this, in a sense.
Cool light. This light needs more light. I wonder what I could find around here to brighten up that nightlight.
I know. I could hack her computer. Wait. I can graffiti things?
I think Rachel could use another subject. But which one?
Oh, bye. Oh, that's so bad.
Rachel's really into stars. I wonder if it's her way of feeling connected.
Well...
I've heard that Rachel and Nathan hang out sometimes, but it still seems hard to believe.
Really? Oh, I can graffiti here too.
Maybe I can make the world a less scary place. On stage, I think Rachel said,
yeah, there we go.
Rachel was incredible as Prospera. I won't forget a second of it.
All right, I already looked at that. Okay, so...
even you, Willie, couldn't come up with the tragedy Rachel's going through.
Flowers?
Hard to believe the show was only a few hours ago. Seems like everything has changed since then.
I know what I can use this for.
At least she'll have something from tonight. I know something Miss Arcadia doesn't. Weird.
Okay. A dragon that matches that that's loose on the town that reminds me of what that one guy said about Rachel being like a dragon made of diamonds. Burn, get it? Huh. Blackwell tuition spike. Okay. Okay. Wait, what did I just read?
I know something Miss Arcadia doesn't.
Bros before bronies? What the Weird. Okay, no, I'm not gonna go down that path, I'm not. I'm gonna just leave it there, because that's, no. Not that. Let's see what's in here. I like to be a sneak.
I could get grades like this. I just don't want to.
Uh-huh. Honors? Tenth grade, huh?
May you always be safe. Sure. But from who?
Don't they see that the lie damaged her more than the... the truth? Hey, Enneagrams, I'm a type 9. Doesn't surprise me that she's a type 4, though, saying that. Hey. What? Wait, what? Damn. Well, that was a quick 12 hours, goddamn. Time flies, I guess, when you're reading text messages.
Is there a section on how to walk fours through batshit crazy family drama? No?
Needlepoint?
The yin and badass yang of Rachel Amber.
Machiavelli. It's just as funny yesterday. Let's see.
We were so close to making our break last night. Now, I don't know. I can't imagine what Rachel is thinking right now. I want her to tell me when she's ready.
Mm-hmm. Here we go. Time for the star show. Wait.
This light needs more light.
Right, okay, so now I use the flashlight. Here we go.
Wonder what I could find around here to brighten up that nightlight.
I think they should suffice. All right. I just put it
for Rachel's light show. Better get her attention first.
Let's do this.
Hey, check it out. It's beautiful. I thought you might like it. I've always loved stars. Why? It reminds us there's so much beauty out there, which we almost never see. Because we're blinded by what's in front of us. Exactly. But then I learned the truth. The stars we're seeing have already been dead for millions of years. They're all lies.
Are they?
But that doesn't make them any less beautiful, right? I don't know. If they're not even real, then what's the point? It's all lies. Everything. My entire life. My dad. My mom.
A little bit of a stretch.
I can't even call it that anymore.
Jeez.
And that other woman, my real mom, she's the biggest lie of all. I can't trust any of them. I think you're the only one in the world I can trust. Take it, even if it's only by process of elimination. Good. I wore this bracelet my entire life. I never even asked why. Never even thought about it. Somehow, I think I always knew. Even when I didn't know. That my real mother was gone. You should take it back. No. There's nowhere else I'd rather keep it than right here.
Projectors are so cool. I used to have one of those when I was little.
The fact that she's here right now, that she came here for me, I think I need to see her. Is that wrong?
Well, certainly not.
Of course not.
it might be tough to track her down.
Yeah. That's true. Luckily, I've got my secret weapon.
Which? Elaborate?
What if we can't find her? It's not like I can ask my dad. I have no idea where to start.
What? What's her secret weapon?
Let me handle it.
Really?
Really.
Mysterious. I like it. Of course, even if we know where she is, we need a way to get to her. I can't just ask my parents for a ride.
Don't worry. I've got that one covered too.
You do?
Yep. In fact, anything you could come up with, I'll handle it. It's just like I told that biker dude at the mill, who was a lot scarier than this mom of yours could ever be. There could be flamethrowers, an army of robot ninjas,
and fucking dragons.
Dragon on a leash between you and her. And I would still find a way to get you there.
Yeah, I'm right.
Chloe fucking Price. My magical Shakespeare fairy.
Shut up.
But once we find her, how do I talk to her? What do I say?
After my dad died, I was worried I wouldn't know how to talk to him anymore. But somehow, when we speak, I always know what to say.
When you speak?
In my dreams. He's there. And it's so real. It's almost like it's another part of my life. It used to be the only part that mattered. I've never told anyone about that. Weird, huh? Rachel?
I was just thinking. Maybe I was wrong before. Who cares if the stars are dead?
It's a spirit.
As long as we can still see them, that means they're real. To us. Right?
Right.
Right.
Oh boy, here we go. Goddamn Raven.
I think we're stuck. Hey, maybe you should let me drive. You always do it wrong.
That was one time. When are you going to let it go? Remember when we used to work on cars together? Those are some of my favorite memories.
Really?
We never... That wasn't... you.
Could have sworn that was me.
The fuck?
All right, you win. Why don't you go take a look?
You sure?
What's wrong? Don't you see anything?
Like what? There's nothing here.
Really? That's odd. Well, I know it's not the spark plug. I just got that replaced.
What?
I said it's not the spark plug!
Huh.
Dad, stop. None of this is real. You're not real. Rachel's family isn't real. This whole thing, it's all just theater.
Well, you know what William Shakespeare said.
Something about the whole world being a stage, so might as well act the fuck out of it.
Nailed it.
I don't want to be an actor. I just want to be myself.
Honest to fucking God.
Give me a break.
Well, maybe there's a reason we pretend. Maybe the lies we tell each other are less horrible than the truths we keep hidden.
Even so.
Wow. That's pretty dark, Dad.
Where do you think you get it from? There's my cue.
Dad?
Relax, sweetie. It's all pretend, right?
Right.
Just a... bit of stage magic. Floodlights, sound effects. Chloe, look at me. Look at me, sweetheart. It's going to be okay.
For fuck's sake. Victoria. Not the time. I mean, it's funny, but not the time. Fuck.
Wait, what the shit? Has someone been going through my room? Doesn't seem like Mom. She wouldn't leave a mess like this. Wait. David? That motherfucker. Whatever. I don't have time for this shit. I've gotta help Rachel. I saw Sarah leaving Frank's RV. He might know how to find her. He might also be totally pissed about Damon's money. I've got to get this exactly right.
No pressure.
I can do this.
Price.
Whoa, Frank. eager much?
Where's the money?
Jeez, would you relax? I have it with me, okay?
I'm coming to get it right now.
I have a favor to ask you.
You can't be fucking serious.
I need to find that woman from yesterday. Sarah. Frank?
What the hell for?
Something important. Can you help? I would really appreciate it. I'm your favorite client, remember?
Me in the junkyard in 2 hours. And bring the fucking money.
Sweet. Thanks, man. You're a real...
What a pal.
That went well, I guess.
Yush.
What am I getting myself into?
That is the question, isn't it? No? Interesting. That's on the text I got yesterday. Just a reiteration of how I'm a badass.
Okay, I've got 2 hours to kill. A shower would be fucking amazing.
Though...
Huh? Mom usually does my laundry when she gets sick of me not doing my laundry.
That feel...
Maybe she believed me for once about never coming back home.
Ah, jeez.
Have I ever watered that?
See, what time is it? I might take a break really quickly and be back. Yeah, I need to take a quick intermission. I'll be back in a few minutes and resume with the plot.